work out of the same box.
Never.
Always multi boxes. This particular floor here has a lock-in system.
Called the lock-in. Yeah. What they call that is the lock-in system.
It's the lock-in system. So what happens is these grooves right here, this is the underside of this piece. This will lock into that. Just like so. And the other piece will overlap and lock the two rows together. And that's how we do it.
It's a locking floor system.
Yes, that's what I said. It's a locking floor system. Okay. But it only allows you to go one direction. You can't work back from this wall. You have to start down that way and work your way this way. And that's it.
Unless
any other floor, you can go both ways.
Dextrous.
Not that we like to go both ways, but we prefer.
Unless you're amphibious.
You didn't hear that from me.
If you're amphibious, you can do it. I think we can do it.
Mike, what's this underlayment for?
Underlayment is for soundproof and a vapor barrier. That sounds good.
What do you got? We also need to explain to the folks that you want to stay at least 7 inches away from this, from your seam, from your next row.
So they don't line up.
You never want to line up your seams.
It'll never work.
Why do you say that?
It'll work, but eventually your floor will fail, and then you have to start all over again. And that could be expensive. So you don't want that to happen. Thank you, sir. Mm-hmm. These we use to put over the seams while we're starting our first row.
Beautiful.
about the new floor going down.
Looks very familiar.
What are you thinking of for, Nick?
Hey, looks good.
Is it too rustic for the office?
Nah.
You think the painted concrete looks better than the wood?
No. Yeah, not at all. What do you think?
It'll be better in the wintertime, boss.
Why, my feet won't get as cold?
Right.
Oh, good.
It's another fine Armstrong product.
It'll be
warmer.
It'll be warmer for my feet.
You need to whack off.